What happens to your brain when you see this? Or this? Or this? It turns out the brain of obese individuals resembles the brain of a person addicted to cocaine or heroin. We all know it's really hard to get rid of such a bad habit of drug use, and it seems to be similar for the bad habit of eating more than our caloric needs. So for most of human history, we were searching for high-caloric foods. Right now, we live in this obesogenic environment. If we walk around on the street, we see food signs, food cues everywhere. Our brain is wired to grab the food, to eat high-caloric foods. And what I'm interested in is, why can some resist the temptation to high-caloric foods better than others? Obesity is already a global epidemic. If we don't stop the epidemic, we'll get even higher numbers of cancer, diabetes. So I hope my research will unravel the mechanisms of the brain. Using MRI, we look at the brain in action. What happens when someone sees gummy bears or French fries or a hamburger? What happens to our brain reward areas?
Okay, Miriam, are you ready for the test?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Good luck.
It's really hard to go back to a normal weight once you become obese. So my research is focused on preventing obesity.
So what we see here is deep in your brain, there's the reward response regions.
We look at individual differences in treatment response, as one treatment might work better for the one person than for the other. So this can be working with a dietitian or newer methods like mindful eating.
So welcome to mindful eating session. We will start with a meditation.
In the mindful eating training, participants learn to be attentive to what they eat. By recognizing eating triggers, we aim to reduce the impact that food cues have on our eating behavior. When talking about the future of food and health, we all face the same problem. To address this problem, we need to look at individual differences. We need to see what works best for who and why. I hope my research will show how we can personalize care or personalized prevention strategies and how we can protect people from becoming obese so the future generation can live more healthily and will have a greater quality of life and life expectancy.